We'll be starting with paper 2. Unit 4. That is metals and non-metals in organic synthesis. Here we have 5 metals and non-metals that we have to study. One is mercury, then organoborane, then we have silicons. Silicons, we will be doing it in 2 parts. One is organosilicons, that is silanes. And second, we will do it with silyl enol ethers. Then we will go for organotin and lastly selenium in organic compounds. Today we will start with this mercury in organic synthesis, where we will study about the mechanism and regiochemistry of oxymercuration and demercuration of alkenes, mercuration of aromatics, transformation of aryl mercurials to aryl halides, and organomercurials as carbene transfer reagents. So organomercury compounds are the mercury salts that we have. Mercury 2, that is Hg2 plus salts are known to be electrophiles. Are known to be electrophiles, like a characteristic of a metal, which add to alkenes and substitute in the aromatic compounds. Across the alkene carbon-carbon double bond, it is getting added, so it is an addition reaction, while in aromatics it is substitution reaction. So substitute in aromatic compounds. First, let us see how this can be synthesized. We know that mercury is the only metal which is found in liquid state at room temperature, but it is reactive and also it is poisonous. So whenever we are doing synthesis or whenever we are dealing with mercury compounds or organomercury compounds, you have to be a little careful while studying this, because it should not be going inside your body. We had Minamata disease. Caused in Japan. The synthesis of this can be carried out in 2 ways. One is the carbenium halide exchange. Exchange between carbeniums and halides, so that mercury halides can be reacted with any organo metallic compounds, particularly lithium and magnesium. So that if you have a mercury halides which is reacting with the RLI or RMGX, then this will give rise to, there will be an exchange between this halogen and this alkyl group between the metals, so that it will have R2HG and you will get lithium halide or magnesium halide. Balance, it will be this way. We can get this particular reaction where X is any halide, particularly chloride or bromide, R is alkyl or aryl groups, can get this on lithium or magnesium metals. And that is organocompounds of lithium and magnesium, we can carry out this particular reaction. Second is that we can do in the second method by methionine insertion reaction. Methionine insertion reaction, where we can do mercury chloride if it is reacted with diazomethane will get one of the chlorides will get exchanged CH2Cl plus N2 will be released outside. Another molecule of diazomethane will give HgCH2Cl twice plus N2. You get the organomercury compounds either by reacting or by this methylene insertion reaction or by reacting it with other organometallic compounds like lithium and magnesium. दूसरे organometallic compounds इसके साथ react करके alkyl group अपना नहीं देते हैं, सिर्फ lithium and magnesium will be exchanged in this alkyl group. We have the reactions of this particular organomercury compounds. Reactions of alkenes with mercury acetate. This particularly reacts very nicely with the alkenes. Mercuric acetate, and it gives us the reagent to start for synthesis of organomercury compounds. First reaction in this can be carbene insertion reaction or carbene transfer reaction. Carbene insertion or carbene transfer reaction. For this, what we do is this can be done by organomercury compounds, that is alpha halo methyl mercury. The one that we have just synthesized, alpha halo methyl mercury, this particular compound can be used for synthesis of this organomercury or carbene transfer reactions. If suppose we have a cis or a trans double bond, the stereochemistries will be different for both of them. If we use same reagent, it will add up in a different way. Like for example, phenyl mercury what we are doing here is this CBr3 will be the source of carbene. CBr3 will be the source of carbene. This is particularly carried out in benzene at 80 degrees Celsius. यहाँ पे ये CBr3 will be source of carbene, where the carbon mercury bond will be broken and what bromine will be released, so that the carbon now becomes divalent carbon. Will have two bromines attached to it, and one of the orbitals will have two electrons, other orbital will be empty, so that the other orbital can take up the electrons and the first orbital can donate the electrons. So it will donate electron to one of the carbons and take up the electrons from the other carbon. What we will get over here is a cyclopropane ring, difficult to synthesize, can be easily synthesized here. And since it was a cis, so the two methyl groups that we have it, that this methyl groups that we have, these two methyl groups are on the same side here in the reactant. So in the product also, they will be on the same side. So this particular stereoisomer we will get as a sole product, and it's the only product here. This suggests that the carbene reaction is happening from one side of the double bond, and it is a simultaneous addition. एक कार्बन पर एड कार्बिन का फर्स्ट कार्बन पे एडिशन एंड देन सेकंड कार्बन पे एडिशन नहीं हो रहा है वहां पर. इट इज जस्ट कि दोनों कार्बन पे एक साथ एडिशन हो रहा है. देन ओनली दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट विल बी ऑब्टेंड एक्सक्लूसिवली. अगर थोड़ा सा भी बीच में टाइम मिलेगा तो दिस कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड विच आफ्टर एडिशन ऑफ कार्बिन विल बिकम अ सिंगल बॉन्ड कैन रोटेट. और अगर रोटेट हो जाता है तो ये स्टीरियोकेमिस्ट्री चेंज हो जाएगी. If we take trans double bond, we will have same conditions, everything same. Just as it is a trans double bond, we will have dibromo cyclopropane ring, but here the methyl groups will be on the opposite sides. The two methyl groups will be on the opposite side. If here it is methyl group, the other methyl group will be on the front side. So the stereochemistry changes very easily using this particular reaction. Control of stereochemistry can be done, that how we want a product, so that we can regulate this particular reaction. The second is example in this cyclohexene. If it reacts with same compound, in benzene at 80 degrees Celsius, we will get same cyclopropane ring. If we take slightly different reagent, where we are exchanging one of the halogens with another halogen, CBr2Cl, same conditions, the product obtained will be dibromo or chlorobromo. Kaunsa product ban sakta hai, or which should be obtained? एक ब्रोमीन तो रहेगा, ये पक्का है. दूसरा यहाँ पे ब्रोमीन आएगा या क्लोरीन आएगा, नो आइडिया. because bromine is a good leaving group than chlorine. The chloride say bromide good leaving group hota hai, and so bromide will be leaving faster than chlorides. And that is why the chloride will stay there while bromide will be going out. Because of its larger size and same charge, bromide are good leaving groups or better leaving groups than chlorides. Similarly, on the same fact, iodides are much better leaving groups than bromides. So this product we can easily get it. Second reactions can be oxomercuration and demercuration. Oxomercuration and demercuration reactions. In this, the reactions usually are rapid. The reactions are rapid in aqueous THF. That is, we have we can take THF as well as water as a solvent, both combination of THF and water. So a phase transfer catalysis can easily happen over here, as there are two different phases, aqueous and non-aqueous phases are there. So reaction can be happening there, and the reaction is thought to be via bridged cation. Reaction is thought to be via bridged cation intermediate. Regiochemistry is dictated by the tendency of formation regiochemistry depends on the stability of carbocation. Stability of carbocation intermediate form. So what happens over here is that if we have, say, an alkene reacting with mercury diacetate in THF water solvent, there will be a loss of acetate ion. One of the acetate ions will be lost, and this mercury will get added across the carbon-carbon double bond with an intermediate, cyclic intermediate. So now what happens is, here mercury is now bonded to 3, so it will be a positively charged. Then there will be loss of one of the mercury carbon bond will be lost or broken. Which one will be broken will be decided by which of these two carbons forms a more stable carbocation. Whichever it forms, it will be forming more stable carbocation should be formed. That is, this bond can be broken or this bond can be broken, either A or B. If it is, say, B and A, if it is B bond is broken, then HG will be added across this bond. So we will have HGOAC, and here it will be a carbocation will be formed. And if it is A bond is broken, then we will have HGOAC, and here it will be a carbocation. Amongst these two, this is primary carbocation, and this is secondary carbocation. We know that secondary carbocations are more stable than primary carbocations. So this is less stable and it is not formed. As it is less stable, it will not be formed. This is more stable. Hence, this one is the preferred route. So after this carbocation is formed, we can add any nucleophile. A solvent like water can act as a nucleophile, or any other nucleophile can be added to get the desired product. So what we have done here is, across the carbon-carbon double bond, we have added a mercury and a hydroxide. So there is an addition of mercury, so we call this reaction as oxymercuration, where we are adding the oxygen or a hydroxide atom on the one carbon and mercury on the other carbon. So we call this as the oxymercuration reaction. If water is replaced by any other solvent, we can get the other solvents also, other products also, we can obtain it. If H2O is replaced by, say, alcohol or acids, that is carboxylic acids, we get HGOAC twice. Here, if we have an alcohol, will have ether will be formed, and if we are reacting it with an acid, say acetic acid or any carboxylic acid, we will have ester as a product. Ester will be the product that will be formed over here. So this is one part where we are adding mercury across the carbon-carbon double bond. But this is generating an organomercuric compound.